The GameCube turns 20 this year, and yet it still commands this unique degree of pop culture and mainstream appeal. Ironically, college kids today probably find the GameCube to be more cool than college kids did back in the day when it launched 20 years ago. Now, I grew up with the more popular PlayStation 2, and while that's the one that significantly more people own, doesn't command the same mainstream appeal that the GameCube seems to. When people talk about games from the PS2 era, it feels to me like they more so talk about different multi-platform hits, and they don't specifically talk about the console itself in the way that people seem to feel about the GameCube. Now, don't get me wrong, the PlayStation 2 had great exclusives, and I used to really enjoy playing Sly Cooper and Ratchet and Clank, but those games don't have the desire for me to go back to the PlayStation 2 the way many of these GameCube exclusives did. Now, if I want to play like Sly Cooper today, I just simply play the PS3 port that it had, and a lot of those other big name PlayStation 2 games have been ported or became available on newer PlayStation hardware, and maybe that's the part of the significance to the GameCube being so culturally relevant yet. Now, unlike the Wii U, which has had the majority of its games ported to the Switch, something that I talked about last week, the GameCube didn't get the same sort of treatment, and many of the GameCube exclusives have never made it off the platform. Besides the recent port of Super Mario Sunshine and the legendary, just awesome Wind Waker port on the Wii U, it's really hard for me to think of many GameCube games that made it onto newer hardware, particularly even newer Nintendo hardware. And that's probably part of the reason why these games are so nostalgic today. And it feels like we're most nostalgic about these things that we can no longer have or we can't have so easily. And the prices on GameCube games have really gone up over the years. Now, that's particularly the case for exclusive, but there's plenty of third-party titles that the same can be said about. Now, I'll always be the first one to argue that the original Xbox is the best place to play really any third-party titles from that generation. I'm sure the PlayStation 2 has a massive library, but to me, the Xbox always led the way in performance, and it's the best one to go back to. But then in that case, why do I find myself playing NFL Blitz or Simpsons Hit and Run on the GameCube, even though it offers the worst experience of the three consoles that those two games were released on? And I guess to just put it in a word, it's more fun to play it on the GameCube. Maybe it's something about that unique shaped control or its different sized buttons that make the GameCube feel more like a childhood toy, I guess, than a game console itself. Or maybe it's just the degree of accessibility. And this is really twofold. On one hand, the system is accessible in the fact that anyone can pick up and play some of its great games. Seems like no matter how unfamiliar you are with video games, you can hand someone a GameCube controller, and that just the weirdly shaped nature of the buttons, the different colors of it, makes it really easy to explain to someone. You know, you hit the green button to jump, or you hit the green button for gas, or you use the single trigger on the left side for this. It just makes it be a lot simpler to explain to someone that hasn't played video games before. But then there's another side to that accessibility point, and it's really that regardless of what the demand and high prices of GameCube consoles appear to be, at least, you know, compared to the PlayStation 2, it's actually really easy and inexpensive to play GameCube games. For one, the Wii is the best-selling console of all time. It seems to be hiding in either your closet or your aunt's closet or your grandma's closet. Everybody you know probably owned a Wii at one point, and many of them, ironically, still have them hiding somewhere. Now, since the Wii can play GameCube discs and even can play GameCube backup ISO files if you have the Wii modded, it makes it be a very accessible way to get different GameCube games up and running on a platform that is very accessible and very inexpensive in the Wii. And emulation on computer is also an option through the Rock Solid Dolphin emulator. Now, I still prefer playing on the original hardware. I think that's easier. I know not everybody owns a computer that's going to run these games very well on Dolphin just because their computer may not be fast enough. But if you play it on the original hardware, you really get the experience just as it should be. But above all, I think the decline of meaningful four-player games, even on the new Xbox and PlayStation platforms, will continue to distinguish the GameCube from newer hardware. Even the Switch, to me, doesn't have all that great of options when it comes to four-player games. I get that there's some, but most of them are being put out by Nintendo, whereas I think that the GameCube just had a wealth of these titles, even third-party titles, even movie tie-in games, I don't care. There was a wealth of four-player games available. And even on the more popular PlayStation 2 with its just two controller ports, you didn't see that. And if you did, you had to have a special adapter for it. So I think that in a lot of ways, the GameCube and really the Wii, because it technically plays both consoles, is the definitive party game console. With how crazy the last year's been and how little you've probably been able to actually go out and do things with your friends, I guess it's really no wonder why people are getting together to play GameCube games in person now, and it seems like such an appealing walk down memory lane, just a nostalgic thing to be able to get together and do in a time where there's few things you can actually go out of the house and do. Having people come over seems so appealing all of a sudden. And if you're feeling nostalgic about playing the GameCube and you've personally gone back to it, I'd love to hear why, see if you kind of have the same train of thought I've had. Anyways, thanks for watching. I'm Bailey, and I will see you in the next video.